Hi, I'm Underbelly, and you suck at producing. Today, we're gonna be making this. Let's get started. Okay, so check it. Let's begin to prove to our friends that, yes, we are very smart, by starting with a blank instance of operator. I'm gonna switch over to the Algorithms tab and change the algorithm to parallel so that none of the oscillators touch each other. Next, we're going to change the number of voices to 1 to make the sound monophonic, and switch over to the pitch section and turn on glide. Let's change the time here to say 150 milliseconds, just so we get a nice big pitch bend from one note to the next. And wowzers, that's the best neural bass I ever heard. We'll switch back over to oscillator A and change the waveform to a square wave. Now, traditionally, neural basses are made with square waves, which sound like this. Let's go ahead and open up the spectrum to just see how the square wave was made. So I'm gonna hold down a single note here, in this case, A. I'm gonna hover over this nice big phallus here. And we can see here that the A I'm playing is at a frequency of 110 hertz. Wowzers. Now that nice big phallus over on the left side is known as our fundamental. But you can see that above that phallus, there's a series of progressively smaller phalluses called harmonics. Harmonics are what give a particular sound, like this square wave, its unique timbre and quality. Now check it out. You can see that these harmonics are tuned to specific frequencies. So for example, we're hovering over the first harmonic here, and we can see that it's tuned to a frequency of 330 hertz, exactly 3 times the frequency of our fundamental. If we go over to the second harmonic, you can see that's tuned to a frequency of 550, and then the next one is 770, 990, and so on. So what we're seeing here is that these harmonics here are tuned to odd multiples of the frequency of our fundamental. Wowzers, now that's a lot of math. I hope my friends really know I'm smart now. Okay, now that's a lot of odd frequency dicks here. Perhaps too many, so let's take it back to the sine wave so we just get that one nice big phallus here. Okay, but hey, I don't know, he's starting to get a little lonely. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do here is slowly bring in oscillator B. And what I'm gonna do here is tune him to the third harmonic so that we're sort of mimicking a square wave by only adding odd harmonics here. So you can see I've tuned it to a course of 3, and there's our second phallus here looking nice and tall. Okay, now looks like our first phallus is, he's starting to get a little insecure here. So I'm gonna go ahead and push oscillator B out to the fifth harmonic. Once again, we're still just doing odd harmonics here because we want to mimic a square wave. Next up, we have oscillator C. Because, check it out, I mean, 2 phalluses is company, but 3 phalluses, now that's a real phallus fest. So let's go ahead and turn up oscillator C. I want to bring up to, say, I don't know, minus 12, and change the course here to 7. Once again, still just doing odd harmonics here. Oh, wowzers. That's a beautiful sausage fest. Now, it looks like oscillator A, he's wanting to get in on the action here, so he just kind of wants to nudge himself a little bit closer. So I'm going to go ahead and turn up the fine here just a little bit, say 15 cents, and wowzers, I'm happy with my phalluses. Now check it out, let's move over to the filter, start messing with this frequency cutoff here, and what we're seeing is past like 300 hertz, we're really not getting that much action from this filter. So what we're gonna do here is click on the operator, hit Command or Control G to group it into an instrument rack. We're gonna right click on this frequency cutoff knob and map it to macro 1. I'm gonna go ahead and rename this macro, let's call it Wumpus, give it an appropriate color, and open up map mode. And what I'm gonna do here is make the maximum value of this frequency cutoff, say 300 hertz, because once again, past that, we were not really getting that much action from the filter. I'm gonna get out of map mode, close this, turn up the resonance to say 50%, just to make the filter frequency movement a little bit more obvious, and take a listen. Okay, we're starting to get some nice wumpus action here. Wowzers, I'm really happy with how we set up our operator. Let's go ahead and add some saturation. So what the saturator is gonna do is, you know, add a little bit of crust, a little bit of crunch to these phalluses. So we're gonna lightly toast them. I'm gonna go ahead and turn up the drive to say plus 25 dB, turn down the output the same amount, just so we're making the volume the same, and turn on some soft clipping, just so we, once again, lightly toast these phalluses. Sounds like this. So there's no saturation with saturation. Wowzers. And now, just to bring out those smoky high notes, let's go ahead and add a little bit of OTT. Now, for those of you who don't know, the OTT is the MSG of EDM. It brings out all the delicious flavors that toasting the phalluses created. But you can see here at 100%, oh man, that's just making me very thirsty, very salty. So let's go ahead and turn down the amount to, say, I don't know, 70%. So we're bringing out the flavor, but we're not asking the customer to reach for their water glass every 3 seconds. Jesus Christ. So here's no MSG, just a little bit of MSG to bring out that flavor. Wowzers. Next up, let's move on, add some EQ. So what we're gonna do with the EQ here is just bring out, say, this phallus right here, kind of around 120 hertz. I'm gonna bring him up just because I think he could really get in on the action. And also keep in mind that around 120 hertz is where most phone speakers, laptop speakers, that's about as low as they can go, just so that all your MySpace friends can really hear this nice big neuro sausage. So we're bringing out that frequency there. And just to really make sure it's shining, let's cut out the frequencies above it so that they're not competing. Wowzers. And finally, what I'm gonna do with my EQ is just bring out the high end there. I'm gonna change this to a bell, just so we get a little bit of that extra crisp brought out there. So just let's see where we're at there. Let's turn this EQ off and back on. Okay, nice bit of extra crisp. Let's check our wampus. Okay, we're starting to get into that serious neurosausage territory. Hopefully our friends know we're very smart by now, but let's keep going. I'm still insecure about my intellect. So I'm gonna go ahead and add another auto filter here. And this time we're gonna go ahead and change this to a bandpass. Now, for those of you who don't know, bandpass cuts both the low and high frequencies out of a sound. So we're getting a nice little wumpus effect. But I think it's cutting a little too much, so I'm gonna go ahead and reduce the steepness of the cut. Let's do 12 dB per octave instead of 24. That's a bit better. Now, sort of like what we did with the first filter, I'm gonna go ahead and find the range in which this filter is really working here. So I'm gonna start from the bottom and slowly sweep up and just see where we can max this filter out. Okay, so I'm noticing around 600 hertz, we're starting to sound less like a neuro bass, more like a neuro squelch. So we kind of don't want to get past here. So once we're at around 600, let's go ahead and right click. We're going to map this to the same wumpus knob that we used for the first filter. Click on map and once again, max this out at, say, I don't know, 600 hertz. We can exit out of map mode now. Take a listen. So I'm going to minimize this stuff just by double clicking. Okay, that's nice and wumpy. Turn down the resonance just a bit, and I don't know. Still, this bandpass is cutting out a little too much of that crisp for me. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on this auto filter, hit Command and Control G to group this into an audio effect rack. And let's go ahead and open up the chain list. I'm gonna rename this chain, call it BP, short for bandpass, and create a new chain so we have two chains. So gosh, and change this chain to through, because, you know, that's not going through the bandpass filter at all. I'm gonna bring down this chain, just slowly bring it up until we just hear just a bit of that extra crisp coming through. So right around there, very subtle. And finally, I think this dish needs a little bit more MSG, and let's add some more EQ as well. So I'm just gonna copy the OTT and EQ8 over so that it's happening once again, this time after the bandpass. And I'm just gonna go ahead and adjust this EQ here. Maybe we don't want so much of that MySpace frequency anymore. So I'm just gonna push this down. Maybe move this around. It's really up to you and your taste, but let's take a listen. Okay, wowzers, I think we're ready for prime wumpus action. So what we're gonna do here is I'm gonna record myself playing this neuro bass off of just one note. In this case, I'm just gonna do F here. And what we're gonna do is try to time the note so that we're playing off this drum groove, and I'll also be manipulating my wumpus knob so I create some wumpuses in time with the groove. So wish me luck. Here we go. Okay, wowzers, that was some serious Wumpus action. Now let's go ahead and check it out. So I'm not really sure if we got all the timing right, so let's go ahead and open up the automation view. First things first, I'm gonna highlight this area here, right-click, click Simplify Envelope so that these Wumps are a little easier to move around. So let's take a listen. So I felt like this one I think could be adjusted a little bit, so I'm just gonna move this point just ever so slightly to the left. Oh, too early. Okay, wonderful. Wowzers, I'm very happy with that Wumpus performance. I think my friends will think I'm very smart now. So what we're gonna do once we're happy with it is right click on this track and hit freeze. And what this does is it converts the MIDI track into audio. And we can simply just copy that down to this new audio track I just created, and wowzers. Now the reason why we're bouncing out to audio is because first off, you get this nice pretty sausage here, nice pretty waveform. Plus it's a lot easier on your CPU, and it's gonna be much easier to chop up and combine with other neural bases later on. So the first thing I'm gonna do is add yet another filter. And I'm gonna go ahead and change this to a notch filter so that we're cutting out frequencies in the middle. And what you'll notice is that the notch creates a sort of phasey effect, sort of like this. And you notice that I'm moving around, I'm sort of timing the movement of the notch filter to kind of coincide with the movement already there in my very smart neural base. So let's go ahead and record ourselves messing with it, see what happens. Oh, wowzers. And last but not least, let's go ahead and add one more filter. And this time I'm gonna go ahead and unfreeze the original track because I'm simply just gonna copy over the audio effect rack we used earlier with our nice little band pass here. I'm gonna unmap this from the Wumpus because we don't need that anymore. And I'm just gonna manually move this nice booby pass right up and down. So let's try it real quick. Now what you might be noticing here is that after I've added this band pass, a lot of the beautiful crunch that our saturator created got cut out. So what we're gonna do here is just simply once again copy over the OTT and the EQ8 one more time and brighten that up. Just adjusting the EQ here to bring out some more of that MySpace frequency. Amazing. Beautiful. Now I'm very happy with that. Just one last step. I'm noticing that there's a lot of dynamic range in this neural base, and I want it to look more like sort of a flat, perfect sausage. So what I'm gonna do is add a limiter. And personally, my favorite limiter to use for this is the color limiter, which comes for free. You can download it as part of the Creative Extensions Pack from Ableton.com. So let's go ahead and turn up the saturation all the way. I'm gonna turn up the color, turn down the release to make the limiter a little bit more responsive, and turn down the ceiling just to start the limiting action. So let's hear it. Oh, wowzers. That's amazing. Okay, so I'm very happy with this. I think my friends will see that we're quite smart here, so I'm gonna freeze this again and finally flatten it. Wowzers, now that's quite a beautiful sausage, but let's make it nice and big just by double clicking and turning up the clip gain here. Oh, jeez, that's just amazing. Okay, now let's go ahead and bring that up here. You might notice that a lot went into this neural base. I mean, there were so many different variables that made it what it was that every time I make a neural base, they sound very different. So check it out. I have a secret stash of neural bases, don't tell Uncle Joe here, that are all a little bit different. We have crunchy, talky, screechy, crunchy, and Chet. Chet. So what I think we're going to do here is I'm going to go ahead and rename this very smart track. I think we've proven our intellect here. I'm going to call this the All-Star track after my favorite band, Smash Mouth. And what we're going to do here is we're going to make an all-star compilation of all these amazing neurobases I've created. So for example, I'll start with, our usual very smart bass. And then maybe over here, I'll bring in some of that trashy bass in there. So I'm just gonna click and drag this clip down. Take a listen. And maybe, I don't know, after trashy, maybe we want a little bit of screechy. So let's drag that down as well. Maybe a little bit of crunch, keep it very smart here. And maybe a little bit of crunchy, you know, just crunchitize me, Captain. Okay, that's very, very nice. Now you might notice that there's somewhat of a volume discrepancy between, say, trashy and screechy here. So I'm gonna go ahead and add yet another OTT just to sort of flatten out this sound and sprinkle some more saltiness on it. Take a listen. Bring up the volume. Okay, amazing. And let me just go back to screechy over here. And finally finish things off with Chet. Oh, wowzers. Okay, so check it. You can see that the traditional approach of making a neurobass is very complex and tedious. So let's go ahead and find a way to perform our neurobasses live. Wowzers. Okay, so check it. What I've done here is create a live neurobass instrument rack. You can see in the instrument rack there are four macros, and I can manipulate each of these macros by using my handy dandy controller called the Touche. If I hold down a note and press down on the Touche, opens up the filter. If I push left, creates a nice bit of screechy FM. Turn it to the right, add some white noise, and finally push up on the Touche. Create this crazy ass grain delay effect. Wowzers. So let's go ahead and, using the Touche and my handy dandy keyboard, perform this neurobass live in the spaces available to us on my All-Star track. Let's get it started. Oh, wowzers. That was a crazy amazing. So let's go ahead, and what we're going to do now is right click on this track and freeze it, just like we did with the earlier neuro bass. I'm going to go ahead and flatten it. And what I'm going to do here is just take these little snippets here and just push them down in the spaces available to us on my All-Star track, just to nice fill up that neuro sausage there. Nice and even there. So just dragging down, and finally, let's take a listen. Man, that's filthy. Okay, so check it. Thank you so much for watching. Once again, you can download the free live neurobass instrument rack in the video description below, as well as a secret stash of my top tier neurobasses. I'm Underbelly. Have a great day.